The Netherlands has had its floods, absolutely. And of course, the trauma of the 1950s is still with us.
The 1953 flood disaster in Zeeland, that was something a lot of people couldn't imagine, and then it happened.
This rare occurrence, the moon and the storm was coinciding and leading to a massive wall of water coming from the North Sea towards the Delta. Basically, the dikes collapsed and many people drowned. That was a reminder for the Dutch that while we happily live at 4 meters below sea level, you have to actually rethink your water management strategy. The Netherlands is also called the Low Countries, and that's very true. So 55% of our surface is actually threatened by water, 29% by being below sea level, and another 26% is threatened because of flooding coming from the rivers, the Rhine and the Meuse.
The delta forms where the river meets the sea, and all the sediments from the river are deposited in a pancake-shaped low plain, and it contains often a lot of wetlands where vegetation grows in an ecological sense very rich. The soils of deltas are very fertile, so you can grow a lot of crops to feed your population and to grow your population. Globally, we are in the order of hundreds of millions of people living in delta areas. Humans move in, they first settle on the banks of the rivers. They discover how to reclaim the land. Reclamation starts with draining it. But with continuous draining, the land starts to subside. Deltas are very much at risk now. Climate change is really going to happen with a major sea level rise. We have to adjust our strategy for the coming decades.
The Netherlands is not only having a problem of sea level rise, it also has a problem of soil subsidence.
So this is a bunker, and it was built between the two world wars. And you can see here that the amount of soil subsidence, and normally it's not visual, but here, because these poles are put in the sand and the sand is not sinking, you can see the real subsidence at the peat. A lot of people have damage in their under houses, and they estimated about 22 billion euros of damage for the coming 20 or 30 years.
We have people from the law department, from public administration, from hydrology, from all sort of fields of academic life collaborating on that particular theme, the incubator of innovation, and in particular interdisciplinary.
It's inspiring. I really like to work together with these different disciplines. And if you have all these disciplines together, you can start now to look into the future.
The university uses as a slogan, bright minds, better future. One of the agents of change for university is precisely the demands of students. They're not socialized into disciplines. They think what they see in society. What we like to do is to also capture that sort of energy and establish new curricula that fit to these sort of needs.
We can serve as a kind of place also for our stakeholders who are involved in policy decisions. And then with our models and our understanding, try to see whether the solutions would be sustainable in the longer future.